5 cents. Okay, you lost, Grandpops. Work over.
Mork driving. Who would believe it could happen here? I keep thinking one stiff wind 4 years ago, and he would have landed in Kentucky.
Come on, Dad. Mork went out, set a goal for himself, and he achieved it. I think you should be very proud of him.
Proud? He just drove out of a gas station with the attendant still under the hood.
Made me laugh.
I'm free. I've got mobility now. I have got my license, the key to joie. Oh, look at this. Look at that. Oh, I can finally take that just married sticker off my bicycle. It was so hard dragging all those cans all these days.
Honey, look, don't think of me as your father. Think of me as your savior. You can't turn that maniac loose on the highway.
Will you have a little faith in Mork, please? He didn't try to discourage you when you took up karate.
Oh, bless you, my little support system. You know, this would be a red-letter day for me if I hadn't taken such a lousy license picture.
Amidst all of this excitement, I've written a poem. Here it is, don't you read. My dad, by Mirth McConnell. Okay? Now that my dad can drive and change a flat, please don't run over my new cat.
Bless you, son, bless you. That was wonderful. I loved your imagery and your meter. You know, it's kind of reminiscent of Hubie or Robert Blake.
Oh, hello.
Hi, I'm Bob Miller, your neighbor from across the street.
Oh, hi.
I seem to have gotten some of your mail. You are Mindy McConnell, aren't you?
Oh, yeah. Oh, and this is my husband, Mork.
Oh, howdy. Hi, Bob. I've seen you. When are you going to take down those Christmas lights?
That's right.
Wow. Hey, isn't that great? Bob, what a kind of guy you are. Why don't you come over tomorrow, wear some shorts, stand by a fire, and have a weenie roast?
You just walked in here and lied to me. You're a process servant. You said you were our neighbor.
Well, I am. I do live right across the street. By the way, can I borrow your rake?
Oh, sorry you have to be going, neighbor.
I mean, come on now. You can't treat people like that. If you do that, they'll be walking their dogs in our lawn.
What's this all about, honey?
I don't know. Oh, ew. They want me to testify in that story I broke on the Hidden Springs Highway scandal. You remember that one, Dad? It was where the road crew told me the contractor was skimping on the safety codes and paying the state inspectors to look the other way.
And now I suppose they want you to tell them who supplied you with the information.
Mm-hmm.
Mommy, I hope you're not going to release the name of the informant. But you stand on the First Amendment and your rights as a journalist. Too strong? It's okay when Lou Grant says it. I can identify with him. They're matching bodies.
I just can't believe that they would ask me to betray a confidence like that. I mean, if it wasn't for me, they wouldn't have the story in the first place.
Well, look, honey, I respect your principles, but haven't journalists gone to jail for standing on the First Amendment?
Oh, Dad, this is just a little construction scandal, not the Pentagon Papers. No, they're not going to do anything to me.
This is Newsline, and I'm Larry Carroll. Today, KTNS reporter Mindy McConnell was cited for contempt of court and jail for refusing to reveal her news source in the Hidden Springs bribery trial. In other news, finalists prep for the Miss Nude Colorado contest, film at 10.
Come on, sister, move it.
You know, I've never been in jail before.
Yeah, life's tough. I've never been to France.
Excuse me, but there's somebody else in there. Maybe I could have a single cell.
Toots, this is jail, not the love boat. Get in.
Wait. Bad question. Are my things gonna be all right? I mean, that's a very expensive sweater. Don't put that on a hanger.
Oh, don't worry about it, honey. I'll only wear it weekends.
Oh, hi.
Oh, you poor dear child. I know just how you feel. Now, you come right here and you sit down. Would you care for a Snickers?
Oh, no. Thank you.
Suit yourself. I was just trying to be friendly.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's just, I've never done time before. I've never even been grounded. I'm Mindy McConnell.
And I'm Louise Bailey.
Hi.
My, but you are a cutie.
Oh.
What in the world are you doing in a hellhole like this?
I don't know. I didn't think things were gonna work out like this. But my lawyer called and she said I should be out in a few hours.
It's funny the way things happen.
Yeah.
I'm in here because of a silly old parking meter.
You're kidding.
No, I went into a hardware store and when I came out, there was a policeman writing me a ticket.
I don't believe it. They threw you in jail for a parking ticket?
Well, in a roundabout way. You see, when I put the shovel in the trunk, Walter's arm fell out.
Who's Walter?
My husband.
Well, what was he doing in the trunk?
Not much. He was dead. I warned him about his snoring for years, but he just wouldn't believe me. So last night, I took a pair of my very best pantyhose and I wrapped them around his neck real tight. You know, it was the first good night's sleep I've had in 31 years.
Well, you look well rested.
You don't snore, do you, dear?
No!
Oh, my poor little prison pooter, my little San Quentin quail, how are you? Oh, Min, I mean, oh, the anguish, the degradation. But cute little dress, though.
Look, I feel so humiliated, even though I know what I'm doing is right. They took everything. They took my clothes and they took my wedding band. And then they fingerprinted me and took mug shots.
Min.
Look. That woman told me that she murdered her husband.
Oh, Mel, murdered her husband? Come on, she looks like Mrs. Cleaver.
Hi.
Oh, how did Mirth take it? Did you tell him?
He cried a lot. He kept saying, Mama's in the can, Mama's in the can. Oh, that's all right, though. Then he packed all your stuff in boxes and he moved in the bedroom with me.
Well, you can tell him to unpack, because I'm going to be out in a few hours.
I got little things to tide you over just in case you're here for a little bit longer. Here's some cigarettes to bribe the screws. And here's some facial cream for an older woman. And here's a harmonica.
Visiting hours are over. Let's go, Shorty.
You got it, Butch.
I miss you already.
I miss you too, Min. Oh, and lady, don't you worry. She makes a real good roommate. Don't let her snore and keep you awake at night.
That was a joke. He was kidding. I don't snore. As a matter of fact, I don't even sleep.
Daddy, it's a long step.
Son, what's the matter now?
What do you mean, what's the matter? Can't you see?
Oh, look, well, sit down. Let's look at the boo-boo. Come on, sit down.
Oh, boo-boo. Doggy bit me, and then there was a kitty bit me, and there was a gray squirrel, and then Tommy Lindner hit me with a bat.
What did you do to make all these people angry?
Just this.
Well, let me look at your boo-boo. Oh, blood.
Hey.
I'll be back. Wait, no.
You've got to set an example. Daddy.
Here we go, son. Don't you worry. Let's put a little of this on there, don't you?
What is it?
No, come on now. If a dog bit you, we've
got... Come on, it's my sore. Let me do the ow.
If a dog bit you, we've got to get a rabies shot for it.
I was kidding about that.
Doggy didn't bite me, and a kitty didn't bite me. But Bobby Denner hit me with a bat. Mommy never puts these on. She always puts
them. Listen, one thing, kid. Your mommy's in the slammer right now, busting rocks and breaking our license plates. So I'm the best you got, but you better deal with me the way you have me right now.
Oh, what am I talking about? I miss Mommy, too.
Boy, you need some sedation.
Oh, son, I'm sorry. Forgive me.
Would you even think of helping me? Boy, it's getting stiff. More. Uh-oh. Gangrene. Watch it. I'm not going to go back. Hurt.
There we go. Come on, son.
Oh. There we go. This is the biggie.
Are you feeling better now?
Yes, I am. Oh, my gosh, that's a doggy. Maybe it's Bobby Denner.
Mark. I'm afraid I got some bad news.
Oh, no, don't tell me something's happened to Gene Rayburn.
No more.
Oh, thank God.
You see, the judge has denied Mindy's petition for release. She could be locked up for quite a while.
Oh, this is awful. Mommy's not coming home for a while. Oh, no, Murph and I are going to be plagued by relatives bringing over strange casseroles like tomato delight.
I'm like Daddy. I'm real sorry about that, but take some extra green. Looks like you lose again.
Amazing. 9 days and she hasn't improved at all.
Oh, Mark, I don't think I can stand it another day.
Oh, darling, I think I have a plan, though, so I can say goodbye to the bars, the community showers, and the mystery meat. Well, just tell them the name of your informant.
No, I'm not gonna do that.
Well, you tell me and I'll spill your guts for you.
Mark, you know how I feel about freedom of the press. This is a basic constitutional question.
Oh, you mean like how Strom Thurmond keeps having children?
What?
Come on, get in here.
Easy, sister. I'm going to have to show you a few tricks I learned in the roller derby.
Oh, man, come on. Now, you got to come home. I mean, I can't bear the thought of you sleeping on anything that doesn't have a dust ruffle.
Oh, believe me, I want to come home. Oh, Mork, it's not easy for me here. When I go out in the exercise yard, the other prisoners giggle when I shoot baskets. I have to cut my meat with a spoon, and frankly, the screws here aren't very nice. Move it, sister, you're on my bunk. Do you believe I said that to her? That woman would kill me for my lunch.
Oh, are they that good here? Oh, man. I'm not just going to sit down and let you rot in here. Now, come on. I'm going to try and do something.
Oh, Mork, what can you do? It's so complicated. You wouldn't know where to start.
Oh, that doesn't matter, Min. I mean, I'm going to go to the Capitol. I'm going to start knocking on doors until someone listens. I'm going to work through the system. I am. I've gone through enough red tape to gift wrap the Kremlin.
How can I help you?
Well, you see, my wife is a journalist, and, she refused to give her sources, so the judge found her in contempt, and she's been in the stir 9 days now, and they haven't even taught her a trade.
That's an outrage. Would you like some coffee?
Oh, no, thank you. I'm not alone in this, though. I have a petition here signed by all 17 members of Miss LaPont's intermediate tap class.
You know, I'd like to thank you for taking the time and the trouble to bring this problem to my attention. Before you go, I would like to present you with one of my souvenir pens.
Hey, listen, if I wanted a pen and coffee, I would have mugged a waitress. You know what? I don't need any more pens. Look at this. I've got pens coming out the clar in here. Look at this. Look at that. Look at this one here. Here's a Ronald Reagan pen. It's got no point. Come on, you're an elected official. I mean, you've got to help people. I mean, you've got to do more than just open up supermarkets and have mediocre-looking daughters. I mean, there's something you can do.
Well, Well, okay. The only viable solution that I can think of is a shield law.
Oh, I mean, is that the law that forces a woman to wear a little pad to protect a delicate dress?
No, it protects a journalist from having to disclose their sources. 26 states have some sort of shield law, but Colorado doesn't. However, they don't have our mile-high taffy.
Well, how about this for a campaign for you, huh? I mean, how about this? Free the Shiks of One. And who knows, in just no time at all, Minnie will be home changing the old vacuum bag.
Hey, okay, listen, I guess I know what I can do. Of course, this is going to take time. This isn't photomath. I'll have to draft a bill and then push it through the right channels.
Right, right.
Yeah, well, then you know what? I won't take my Christmas vacation.
Oh, bless you.
And I'll ram this thing right
through. I'll ram it home.
Yes, sir. And you know what? She'll probably be out in about 2 or 3 years.
2 or 3 years? By that time, Brooke Shields' eyebrows would have met.
Hey, listen. That's not so bad. You know, it took me 2 full terms just to get this swivel chair.
Well, then you can't get my wife out of jail.
No, but my father could have. I'm sorry. It's not that I don't care. It's just that, well, I don't want to make waves.
Oh, you don't want to make waves? Well... Oh, you politicians. You politicians are all alike. I should have known better. I mean, from the same system that gave us Spiro Agnew.
Happy birthday to you.
Hey!
Birthday? What are you doing?
Oh, we listen to her. She's so shy. She lies about her age and her SAT scores.
You know, you've got a funny little man here. A cake in the shape of a saw.
Say along with me, Minda. We're making our own laws here, just like in Haiti.
Whatever you're up to, please don't.
Oh, she's gonna perk up so much we make those little balloon animals.
Oh, gee, good. You know, we haven't had a party here since the police chief had his heart attack.
Party! Ow! Party! Well, Min, well, I saw this cake, and it's the best one I'd seen, bar none. Hope it doesn't make you break out. Break out. Well, make a wish, hon.
I did, but you're probably going through with this anyway.
Oh. A couple of weeks without her water pick, and she still hasn't lost her spirit.
Well, time to cut the cake.
Yeah. Oh, but there's no tradition that the birthday girl gets to cut the cake.
Well, we have a little tradition here, too. Prisoners with knives get shot on sight.
Ooh.
I want my piece of cake now.
Oh, yeah.
What kind of filling is that?
Well, I asked for rum raisin. Oh, boy. I'm gonna call my consumer advocate about this. Whoa, watch out for this one. Oh, that really, oh, ooh. Oh, what a bummer. Watch out, oh, whoa.
Hey, wait a second. Did you really marry that guy, or are you just breaking him in for somebody else? Back here.
Hop on the Midnight Express. Come on.
I want you to stop this right now.
Oh, Min, come on now. I need you. Murph needs you. And besides, you got tickets to see sophisticated ladies. Now, come on.
No.
Oh, Min, listen. I mean, it's clam night at Howard Johnson's. Min, come on now, please. Well, stand back. Stand back.
No.
No, Min, come
Mork,
on now.
Stop it.
Stand back.
Mork, put that finger down.
Min. My car's outside, the engine's running, and besides, you don't want to miss clam night. Come on, let's go.
It's against the law to break people out of jail.
Well, so is dancing with sheep, but people still do it.
Oh, I want to go with you, but I can't. Oh, Mork, don't you see? This is my one chance to prove that my beliefs are more than just words. My mind's made up. I'm not going anywhere. I'm staying here.
Min, are you the same woman that broke the Pritikin diet after only 3 hours?
Yes, but that's different, Mork. Sometimes you have to make sacrifices for your principles. Oh, come on, you see that, don't you?
Oh, no. No, come on, Min.
All right, freeze, what? Shrimp.
Wait, you boys play handball someplace else.
No, that's not going to work.
You're under arrest.
Oh, please. Oh, no, wait. This is a mistake. This is a misunderstanding. Come on,
we'll
just have
humor. Well, listen, woman, we'll look at the good side. I mean, I'm here, you're here, and if they get mirth on a juvenile rap, we'll be a happy family again.
You could have saved yourself the trouble. Pollyanna here has been released. Your source finally spilled the beans.
You're kidding, I'm free! Oh, God, I can't wait to get out of here.
Oh, but Min, you ex-cons are so insensitive. Min,
what about me? Come on, Toots, let's move it.
Oh, Min, you can't leave me in here. You know what happens to a pretty face in jail.
I'm gonna go straight home and call the lawyer, all right?
All right.
Okay, I'll call. Oh, you might need this.
Oh, all right.
Oh, and don't eat the macaroni, it's bad.
Yaddy yaddy! Wait a minute. What am I feeling sorry about? There's no jail in this town that can hold me on clam night.
Born free.
All those years in the roller derby, I knew I should have worn a helmet.
This is Newsline, and I'm Mindy McConnell. Heavy rains today bring flash flood warnings to Colgate County. Today, Denver Gazette reporter Judd Smith was cited for contempt and jailed for refusing to reveal his news sources in the Arvada kickback trial. In a related story, a bill to provide a shield law for journalists died in committee. And the manhunt continues for escaped pantyhose strangler Louise Bailey. Details at 10.